All right, so today is what's the date? April 28th. It's our first installment of the Mount Rushmore drafts. We actually went over very many different ideas for this project, so this is kind of a last minute thing, but we also think it's going to be good. Today we are drafting teachers that we think would be good in the military.
It's a play on words because it's a literal draft.
It's a draft of drafts, and today or this week is also Teacher Appreciation Week, right? Hunter, you said that, I think?
This week coming up, yes.
Okay, so I think this will fit well.
This will come out during Teacher Appreciation Week, so.
And everyone want to go around and introduce themselves so everyone knows?
All right, I'm Brady. I got the first overall pick, so.
I'm Tryston. I got the second overall pick.
I'm Hunter. Got the third pick.
And I'm Jacob. I got the last pick.
And it's a snake draft, so.
Right, so the person with the last pick in the first round has the first.
The first pick in the second round.
And
vice versa.
All right, so are you guys ready?
Of course.
Never been more ready.
Brady, you go first.
All right, so my first overall pick, it's basically already said, Mr. Kuchas. No explanation needed.
No, give us an explanation.
Are you serious?
Why would you pick Kuchas?
Dude,
you don't
know?
He
can program anything and everything.
He has past military experience.
And yeah. Power goes out.
He'll make a generator.
Yeah. I had a second round grade on him, not gonna lie.
Wow.
Seriously?
He is.
Wow.
No.
He's probably the smartest guy in the school.
No, he is.
He really is.
Brody's not even on my draft board.
He, imagine the ping pong in the barracks.
Yeah.
How much chemistry that military would have together?
Yeah, if us in like Iran or something like that, if we had a ping pong tournament, maybe he'd be good, but.
Well, who says we won't have one?
I don't know. Forget it. Who's got next pick?
All right, I've got next pick. And I don't know if you guys have him, so it might be a bit of a...
Actually, before you go, doesn't Mr. Kuchas only play ping pong on Tuesdays?
Something like that.
So that's a 1 out of 7 chance. He gets a chance to play ping pong against other countries.
But if he's in charge, he can dictate what day they play.
Is he in charge?
Yes.
Okay.
Is he?
I just wanted to settle it.
Yeah. All right.
So, with the second overall pick, I'm not sure if you guys see him as a sleeper because you may not have him. He's new. I'm taking Senior Wagner. He speaks, like, legit 6 languages. Pretty, very fit, I would say. Mm-hmm. And I think he would be a great leader because he could conversate potential peace treaties as well as be a soldier. He's fit and ready.
We don't need these.
So he's like your foreign ambassador.
Oh, he's the jack of all trades.
He is.
Yes.
What is what languages does he speak?
What do I English?
Oh.
Spanish, German, Portuguese, and then in class he'll randomly just say other languages that only he understands. It's amazing. So
I mean, I guess you can't really argue with it. How many people can speak different languages in the school, let alone 6.
Yeah, so I'm going with my man, Andrew Wagner.
All right, I got my first pick still. You guys both missed him. I got Coach Preston. I think that there's just no explanation. He will go out there. He'll get everyone ready.
You're explaining right now.
He'll get, yeah, well, yeah. He'll get everyone. Your pick.
That's a great pick.
Just go ahead and explain.
Well,
just don't contradict yourself off the bat, though.
Okay, I'm sorry. Well, he's going to get everyone hyped. He's a great leader. He's going to get all the troops ready. He's going to be a great general. He's going to send them out there and win. Go 1-0.
Today.
Today.
I can't argue with that.
Preston versus the world.
All right, well, my number one pick is also still here. And I think in a day and age like today, I think we should all know we have to be prepared for, you know, what we don't see coming. COVID. It sent everyone virtual. So in this hypothetical scenario, let's say there's another COVID-24. War goes virtual. I have no clue what I'm freaking doing. Me and my soldiers, we don't know how to work a Chromebook. Are you kidding me? We're out in, you know, Afghan, just with no power. So we need a e-learning coach. Number one pick, I'm taking Mrs. Reinhold.
Wow.
She is the tech warrior, is she not?
The tech warrior.
Exactly.
War goes virtual. I mean, no one else is, I mean, everyone else is just going to be, you know, quarantined up.
No one's more fit than the tech warrior.
I mean, we'll be the most prepared 100%.
Definitely didn't have her on my draft board.
I knew you guys didn't, and that's why I took her.
You could have waited a little bit.
All right, second pick. This is the first pick of the second round, so it's back-to-back. Let me paint a picture for you guys.
Please do.
Hunter, you play sports. Tryston plays sports. Brady, you can imagine playing sports.
Maybe.
Let's say you're on your way to your event or your sport. Everyone needs music to get hype. The whole locker room needs to be bopping. Shout out to Baby.
And Fortnite.
You need some good music to get you fired up. Who else is going to bring you the best music? Mr. Sampson, band director. If you're trying to get hyped with no music, just the sound of your breath, you already lost the game, let alone a war that decides the future of your country. Therefore, Mr. Sampson, you are my second overall pick.
Can't say I agree with that.
I do not like that.
All right, explain.
I think there's someone better, and I have intentions of taking them for later on.
For a music person?
Mm-hmm.
Your first pick was circumstantial, and your second one is, I mean, not very necessary.
Every 100 years, there's a pandemic.
Yeah, we still have like 90 years.
But in about 40 years, we're going to be able to learn how to, you know, lengthen our lifespans. So therefore, Mrs. Reinhold is still valuable here in about a couple centuries.
Okay, whatever you say.
I understand. Reinhold is much better. She is a tech warrior.
All right, with my second pick, Jacob made a great point with the music, but you also cannot fight on an empty stomach. I'm going with Mr. Sample. I think that's a great pick. He's going to keep the troops well-fed, well-ready. Jacob, you are raising your hand.
Sure, he knows how to cook food with food that is given to him. An agriculture teacher, on the other hand, grows her own food. So I think that pick was just one of the dumbest picks I've ever heard.
But think about it. If you're out in a war, you're not going to have time to start growing food. You're gonna have the meal ready.
Where's the food gonna come from? The sand?
My soldiers are gonna have MREs on site.
Yeah, exactly. They're gonna have stuff like that. And guess what? Sam's gonna make them taste better. He's gonna add some little salt.
They already have pre-planned meals. What's the point of a
salt, pepper?
Sounds like a waste of pick.
Sounds like you just need a salt shaker.
Well, he's gonna make it taste better.
I think we completely debunked your whole pick.
Yeah.
Okay. Dumb pick. Who's next?
Tryston, you're up. All right.
I got my second pick. And I came unprepared with no draft board, but, you know, Eddie here brought up a great point at the music. Music is very important to the overall mood.
Jacob is also Eddie, by the way.
Yeah.
Just a disclaimer.
It's nickname. But I'm going to go with Kate Lang, the percussion band director. I've had her middle school drop band, but music is nothing without the beat. She brings the beat. Okay. And she can direct as well. I've seen that. And she will get you on track, I swear.
So what you're telling me is, if you're getting hype, you look up drum instrumentals instead of, you know, maybe Migos. On the other hand.
She's a full... Imagine Migos without the beat.
Samson's the band director, not just the percussion director.
As well.
Yeah, she can do just as much.
She can do more.
I'll allow it.
She's not going to direct. Samson's not going to direct Migos.
Imagine Migos with no beat.
Exactly.
Samson doesn't...
Pure dung, which is poop if you were...
Samson, he directs the whole band. That's including drums.
So can Lang. And Lang can play the drums herself. Who says that one of these soldiers know how to play the drums?
I bet Samson can.
All right, whatever. I think you won that argument, but we'll talk later.
Brady sure will.
My second pick, did not think he was going to go this far at all. Biggest teacher in the school, Mr. Nunn.
Oh,
Coach Nunn.
I forgot to write that down.
Have you ever heard of the story David and Goliath?
First round grade on him as well.
Have you? A biblical story.
You explain.
Okay, so Goliath is just this huge monumental man, 7 foot whatever. David, just an average guy, 5 foot, you know, maybe 9. One slingshot to the eye, Goliath goes down.
Oh, well. He can still squat you, so it'll be okay.
He'll squat a tank to get it out of the way.
Yeah, if you can squat a lot, he definitely can defend a rock to the eye.
Didn't he just squat like 670-something pounds? No spot.
Yeah, that video did have no spotter. Kind of dangerous.
Kind of awesome.
Also kind of awesome. Brady, you go again.
Third pick, you got to have a nurse. So I'm going to go with Miss Stacy Eiler.
Let me debunk your whole pick.
Okay.
You get shot in the leg in war. Ow, my leg. Here, honey, here's a breath mint. Go ahead and lie down. That doesn't work.
And crackers.
I'll send you home here in a minute once your mom picks you up. You're on the other side of the earth. You're not getting picked up. That mint is not working.
But if she gives you an ice pack, though.
Something's better than nothing.
But I think that this is a double whammy because the nurse ladies have crackers. That's food as well.
Dude, fair, they are the supplier, too.
All right, forget the whole mint thing. The fact that she has crackers just overtops my ruling. All right.
And when you were in elementary school, if you had something messed up and you got an ice pack, you were okay. Like there's something in those ice packs.
And that's ice cold water for later on. So you're also getting hydrated. All right, that might have been the best pick. I'm sorry. I retract all my statements.
All right. Now, I'm back up for my third pick. And I think I'm going to go with Mr. Lukic. He is legit just an overall genius. And if you see his plans page, organized. And he's willing to put in time. He's here at school, 7 a.m., 3 p.m. every day. 3:30, my apologies. He gives you 15 options to do whatever you can. And he knows everything you could need to know about potential math situations. Say if it's the slope of a tangent line of a grenade, he got that.
By the time he figures it out, though, the grenade's already exploded. Mm-mm. No?
I swear, he slows it down for us. But in his head, it's just instant. He's quicker than a grenade.
Yeah, I can picture the other army saying, you know, talking their war plan. Someone running in the door, holding up pieces of paper. We've learned something new. They've got a math teacher.
Dude, and we could code in integrals and derivatives?
Ms. Gooch is a better pick.
What? You haven't seen the organization.
Next pick.
Okay, next pick. Hunter, go.
All right. My third pick, kind of stuck between a few people here, but I am going to go with Mr. Van Horn. Science teacher. Very smart. You know, he's kind of goofy in the classroom sometimes, but overall, that's just going to add on to his personality. When times get rough, he can make people laugh.
He can play soccer.
Little comedic relief.
If a grenade falls into the trench, he is going to kick that thing back into the other one.
He also knows all the conspiracies, so he's prepared.
That is true.
But what if there's a light breeze? He flops on the ground, waiting for the ref to pull out the red card.
He used to play soccer. Mm. Not anymore. But now he coaches it, so he doesn't do that.
You want your soldiers to get taught that?
No, not necessarily. But I'm not going to have them teach him that. You have to realize, in this situation, I am still in charge.
Do you really want a soldier in your battle with the first name of Justin?
Well, no, not necessarily, but... But he's a scientist. Even if he's not on the front battlefield, he'll be back, and he'll be studying stuff. And they'll come up with new ideas, new weapons, new cures for stuff. I mean, I trust him completely.
All right, I'm back up for my third pick. This is the last pick of the third round. What do a lot of soldiers have when they come back from war?
PTSD.
PTSD. Who do they need to comfort them and talk them through their PTSD?
Mr. McMillan,
a counselor. He is on the mental side of war. He will get us mentally in shape, maybe not physically so much, but we will definitely try our hardest. I mean, some of these PTSD guys are just jacked up to the max, and you hate to see it. So I'm going to pick Mr. McMillan with my third pick.
See, you're always hating on all of our picks. But, like, right there, like, what's it going to do when they come back to war?
Make their schedule. Change their schedule.
And he runs, he's a state champion in cross country, too. He could go Forrest Gump.
You guys are just making my pick for me. I mean, it gets better as we continue to speak.
Go ahead, then.
All right, this is the first pick of the last round. When you think physical intimidation in this school, who do you think of instantly?
Coach Nunn.
Bengal.
There is one other person I think of. That is Mrs. Yost. Let's say there's an uphill battle. You guys are trying to get control of high ground. And you see Mrs. Yost come over the horizon. We're instantly retreating. History buff as well. She knows what to do, what not to do.
History repeats itself.
History does repeat itself, so she's not going to let you guys do that. She's going to make sure that you guys win battles. I do agree with that.
That is valid.
I think Mr. Nunn has nothing on Mrs. Yost.
She is very intimidating.
Coach Nunn.
Say it proper. Say it loud.
Coach Nunn. Coach Nunn. Say it 3 times. All right, next up is...
It's me. Hunter. So, my 2 through 4 are still there, but, you know, I kind of skipped over. This might be a shocker. I'm going to pass up on 2 really good picks, but I'm going to go with Mr. Corley as my last pick. And the reason I'm going to go with Mr. Corley, you know, very tech-savvy. You know, records everything, gets everything documented. He can document war crimes. He can document the other side messing up and doing some horrible things, get other countries to help us, and just overall bring in, you know, another thing. He can, you know, get videos and get more people interested in joining the war. Everyone has their hand raised right now, so I feel like I'm going to get pooped on.
So I'm going to say this. I'm going to say I think that's a pretty poor pick because Imagine the sniper glare his dome gives off. If you look over the horizon, the pure glimmer off of his scalp would just give your whole barracks away and your soldiers would be at risk.
At the same time, though, he's not going to be on the front lines. In this situation, I got to choose where he
How's he going to get a good angle?
He's basically a secretary.
He needs the best angle possible.
And again, though, his head is almost like a second sun. Could blind people. No, I'm saying that's good for Hunter.
It would work as a bat signal just telling people where we are.
But it's also like a helmet.
Don't think it's bulletproof.
I also don't think it's bulletproof.
I think it could definitely be dented.
I think it's more of a visual thing. Brady, you had your hand up next.
I already said it, but you hired him as a secretary, essentially.
I mean, yeah, I could, like, if I really wanted to. My little friend.
True.
No, he's a cool guy to talk to.
You gotta think, though, it's 2021. Everyone's tech savvy these days.
Your first pick was Miss Reinhold.
Also true.
She's the most savviest.
But she's a tech warrior.
It's in the name.
Is she going to be there when it happens? No. Corley will be.
That's fair.
That's valid.
He's there, getting every angle. He's
there. Is Mr. Corley safe, proactive, and responsible?
Yes, the warrior way. Yes, he is.
He does entitle the warrior way.
I was going to say a good thing about Mr. Corley, but I forget it, so. Tryston, you are up next.
I'm actually surprised this guy is still out here. I think he should have been taken at least second round. But I'm going to go with Bengal, Coach Bengal. Has he seriously not been taken yet?
No. Nope.
Really?
For what reason?
Oh, so many. Have you seen the way he runs the track team?
Is he going to teach your soldiers how to hurdle? Is that what he's going to do?
He's also a health teacher as well. He could have our soldiers in the tip-top shape that they need to be in the easiest possible way, as well as run them fluently. Have you seen the track meet? How many things he has going on? He runs that perfectly.
I would make fun of your pick, but there's a conflict of interest, so.
Yeah.
Hey, untouchable. I think that's a sleeper pick.
He actually was going to be my last pick, but kind of chose Corley there.
I'm very shocked he's still here.
I guess, put that on the record, Hunter did choose Corley over Bengal.
We're cutting that.
Corley over Bengal. All right.
He's got priorities. Mr. Irrelevant, last pick of the draft. I think this is a pretty good pick. Mr. Webb. He's an engine. He's a teaches engineering, teaches construction. He's a quarterback's coach. What doesn't he know?
Imagine how far he could throw a grenade.
Exactly. He used to be a quarterback for, what was it, Purdue?
I almost want to say definitely not, but...
I'm going to, go ahead and say that.
He was a quarterback.
But Purdue?
I almost want to say definitely not for Purdue. I do say that's a good pick, though. Something needs built, it gets built instantly.
Yeah. I'm a big fan of grenades. I can just imagine all soldiers know how to throw a grenade perfectly, a perfect dime, perfect spiral.
It would be a lethal army.
And he can make more grenades.
Lethal weapon.
All right, well, now that's just a replenishing wheel.
So, it's a beautiful machine. Should we do a recap of...
You guys want to go over honorable mentions real quick?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Mr. Coons?
I did think of Todd Coons, the Todd father.
I had Mr. Coons in my top five as well.
Pretty big dude. And he's tech savvy.
Exactly.
And he's raising a quarterback.
Exactly. He's also raising five kids.
Yeah, he could raise the whole army by himself. Yeah. Basically, he is already.
He used to coach my Little League baseball. I hit dingers.
He used to coach the 1 year I played football and scared me as a kid, you know?
On my honorable mention list, I had Mrs. Lipsy, the art teacher. It's a very stressful time, war is, and if you don't get to express yourself, you might get into a dark place. So to prevent depression or any mental illnesses, we draw it up.
Who's going to fight your war for you?
Our generic soldiers. We've gone over this.
You have all these people, like, getting tech, you know, making music, talking about their feelings.
We're more of a liberal arts army. You really don't know what it does, but you have a degree.
So who's going to lead your army? Oh, seemed to...
Looks like we're sitting on the bench. I don't know. Yeah. I mean, I guess I will.
It's like me in Bantam League football.
You're going to be out there on the front lines?
Let me go over my picks real quick. Mrs. Yost?
That is true.
I'm not going to lie, I have never had her, so I cannot.
She loves bingo. I love playing bingo in her class.
Any other honorable mentions?
I had Shaler.
Yeah, I had him on my list.
We like to call him Jumpman.
There's nothing scarier than the man with the Jordan tattoo on his calf.
In the van, dude, you carry around all the soldiers.
Beats walking.
I had also Mr. Bashinsky / Mrs. Larkin. And Mr. Holman, if any of my soldiers aren't in check, they will get them in check. Very quick, yeah. And it's almost like an ISS type beat. But
instead, they make you sit on the front lines, no weapon.
Yeah. You have to do hand-to-hand combat, even though it's a gun war. I also had Mr. Betts, because if you can lead a public school, I think you can lead anything.
Yeah.
I had Fisher.
I did have Fisher as well.
Fisher's a great coach. I mean, I think he'd be a great leader, too.
We'll dip because Preston is such a big influence.
Yeah, I had Preston first. I
want to say one was greater than the other.
I just didn't want to pander to the people. I felt like that was a very chalky pick.
I had Mr. Who was it? Cornelius.
What's wrong with you?
Cornelius for what?
Anything and everything. He reads like 200 books a year.
That's a big change from a month to a week to a year.
I screwed up a little bit. Okay.
I had Gillespie, too, as an honorable mention, because he'll have the stats on everything, dude.
Mm. You don't know the power of stats.
That's true.
The power of stats is...
Knowing your probability puts you in amazing positions.
He'll get sidelined by tennis elbow.
Get that man a tennis racket, he'll make something happen.
That maybe wouldn't have been... Maybe... was one of the worst whistles I've ever heard.
Had to be gentle for the viewers, or the listeners.
All right, let me do it real quick.
That's a good one.
That just pierced the ears, but it was worth it.
They are bleeding.
All right, so do you guys remember all your picks?
Yeah. Yes, I have them.
Do you want to recap real quick?
All right, I'll go first. I have Mr. Kuchas at the one. The number two.
Maybe give like a real quick reason why.
Oh, Kuchas was, he basically knows everything, like coding. Engineering.
Work for the military.
Yeah, basically.
This is his time, Tryston.
Number two was Stacy Eiler, the school nurse. She knows a lot. She can help us out, bring those crackers, ice packs, ice water, of course. The third was Coach Nunn. No explanation, really. He's just a tank. He could take anything and everything. And the fourth, Mr. Webb, teaches engineering and construction. You can build stuff, engineer stuff, whatever you need.
Tryston, go.
All right. For my first overall pick, I took Senior Wagner from Spanish Hallway because he's very fit and in shape, and he is like dodecalingual and could negotiate any treaty imaginable with any person on this planet.
No, that's definitely a word.
That was a big word.
Dodecalingual?
Dodeca is 12.
Yeah, you said 6.
You said 6 earlier, so let's get your story straight.
Dude, I don't know.
Does this guy even speak any languages at all?
English.
All right, next, all right, go ahead, continue, sorry.
My second pick was Kate Lang. But going off of your music idea, I thought it was such a good idea. But I had to go in deep into the roots of music and get the beat. The beat is what matters, and she can direct as well. So that's why I went with Kate Lang there. And then my third pick was Mr. Lukic, because his organization and commitment is off the charts, unlike any other teacher I've ever seen, as well as his preparation for due dates and exams. It's just perfect. And then my last pick, I somehow snagged him in the final round, was Coach Bangle. I mean, that just speaks for itself. He's fit, knows how to get fit, can run things with ease, natural leader. I think that's just a sleeper.
I do think that was a very good pick. I do know who I think is my sleeper of the pick, though, but that wasn't me. Who got it? My first pick, I had Coach Tryston. Pretty self-explanatory. I knew coming in that that was going to be my first pick no matter what. I'd have to fight someone for him. Coming out of Lake Forest, I mean, what else could you want? Like, I mean, he's a born leader. He's, you know, gets everyone hyped. And have you seen the man in the weight room? He's a tank. I mean, he's just as strong as anyone, pound for pound, in the school. I believe so, anyways. Second pick, I got Sample. Sample, you know, cooking up the food for the troops, keeping them well fed. I see you shaking your head, Tryston, but then again, your troops are not going to be as well fed.
MRE is all we need.
I have crackers.
Well, my third pick, that I have is Mr. Van Horn. I said some dude to be goofy on the back line, some dude to study stuff, you know, come up with maybe chemical weapons, bioweapons, I don't know.
Those are outlawed.
But who's to outlaw them if we just win the war and take everything?
Just make another treaty, no more. Outlaw.
Exactly. And then my last pick, Mr. Corley. He'll document all the war crimes of the other countries, not us. He'll get other people, you know, he'll make hype videos for the war.
He controls the news.
He's pretty much the news.
And all the social media outlets.
Keep the people updated.
Lord help us.
He'll push out our propaganda, and he'll keep us ready for the war. So, Jacob?
My picks were Mrs. Reinhold in case of an e-war to guide us and help us through that. Second pick was Mr. Sampson, get us hype, obviously. You're nothing without music. Music is everything. Everything is music. I'm pretty sure Socrates said that at some point. Mr. McMillan, in case of PTSD, it's a lethal disease, horrible. Shout out Louis Zamp, Unbroken, great book, great movie. And then last, Mrs. Yost, physical intimidation. No one is getting around her. No one's getting through her. No one's getting over her. So I think it's just she's one big brick wall.
I think that was the steal of the draft.
Yeah.
Personally, I think it was a really good pick.
All mine were steals, so.
Yeah.
Whatever you said.
Should we clap off?
Hey, it's been a pleasure. Episode 1. Hopefully, it's a weekly installment.
We might do this again.
If our provider doesn't cancel us.
This is the pilot episode.
Yeah.
We're on a contract, so.
Please help us.
If you don't hear from us again.
Bad things happened.
All right.
Thank you. See you next time.